them. In Bahrain, it's not enough for the government to commit a crime. Part of the crime is to silence whoever is dared to speak about the crime. And they wanted to teach the people a very good lesson about what it means to dare to speak about a crime that the government has committed. But those people, imagine a father which lost his son. How much pain this could be. Or a mother which out of a sudden has lost her child, and she lost her husband as well. Her husband is still stuck in a prison cell. These testimonies which we hear every day really moves us, shakes us. I mean, I had the privilege of speaking to some of their martyrs. Some of those martyrs have died is because of the excessive use of force by the government. This is the story of Ali al-Sheikh. A tear gas canister in his neck destroyed his life. But then there was untold story about those individuals which were executed by the regime. And that means that this is a planned murder. This was a murder. Those three men, Abbas al-Sami', Ali al-Sangis, and Samim Shami', were executed by firing squads on 15th of January 2017.
Anyway, the hope is that our meeting today will echo somewhere across the road to, in the ears of those who have the power to do something, who have the power to make a change. But will they do that? Will they heed these calls? Unfortunately, we do not live in a world of morality, of ethics, but or justice. But we hope that our cries will one day will reach to those in power, especially the UK, which is responsible for, I think, for much of what has been happening ever since they left the Gulf in 1971. With these words, I'd like to thank everybody, and we are open to some comments and the questions. And Father Frank Jelly will start this.
Just a brief question about the role of former Scotland Yard top cops in advising the security forces in Bahrain, which you've just seen what they're capable of. How can Scotland Yard, how can the Home Office justify advising these murderers and torturers in perpetrating their crimes?
So who would like to say something about the role of the British police in advising the Bahraini police, the inspection team, the inspection that Her Majesty's Directorate of Prison Inspections.
You as a British citizen.